it's gonna look kind of funny in the dark.
Merci beaucoup.
So we are the Multiverse TV, so this interview is for the festival. It's not press or media, radio. It's
for just for Montreux Festival, huh?
Yeah, the Multiverse TV.
All right. Well, I'm a trombone advocate, you know, because the trombone is a beautiful instrument, and you know, I really feel bad that a lot of people don't play it. You know, they usually gravitate toward the guitar and the saxophone, you know, and I would really like for more people to learn how to play trombone. The trombone is a lovely instrument if it's played correctly, and like you said, J.J. Johnson and trombone, Charlie Curtis Fuller, Slide Hampton, they all play it very nicely, you know, so you should listen to these people and, you know, try to learn how to play the trombone. You know, I'm an advocate for the trombone. So I'm known as a creator of funk, but it wasn't my intention to create new music. But, you know, as music evolves, all music is new. So the same way Trombone Shorty follows me, the same way John Legend follows Marvin Gaye, you know, it moves forward. It moves on. So it's constantly evolving and becoming new music. We wasn't conscious. We didn't consciously create this music. It was just created out of doing what you thought was right, or what Maceo thought was right, or what Pee Wee, or Jane Brown, or Bootsy, whatever they thought was correct, they did it, and it turned out to be funk music. I didn't realize it at the time, but music did unite the people, you know. We did tunes like Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud, or Fight the Power, and stuff like that. It was just done at a time when it was needed to be said, and it did unite masses of people. When I was with James Brown, it was difficult, you know. It's like having a strict father, you know. He'd be telling you things, and you listen at him, but you don't really understand what he's talking about until later, you know. But he was strict. He was a strict man. He had to run his band the way he did. And he had rules, and we had to follow these rules. But he was hard to work for, but he did a lot of good things, and so that's what we like to focus on, the good that he did. But I came here first in 1978 with the great Count Basie Orchestra. Yeah, that was my first experience with Montreux. In 1978, I came here with Count Basie. Count Basie was part of a big show with Joe Pass, Ella Fitzgerald, Oscar Peterson, Niels Pettersson. But now it's more eclectic. You know, you have jazz and funk and R&B, all kind of music. You know, I play all of it, you know. But you have a lot of different bands with a lot of different styles.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, Eduardo.
Have a nice evening, and thank you for the gig tonight.
Can you come tonight?
Yeah, of course. I'll be there, right. Back there for the staff.
All right.
Et j'ai essayé, mais ça n'a pas marché. Pendant longtemps, elle s'est dit bon, bah, c'est peine perdue. C'est pas grave. Et tout d'un coup,
but when we travel, I don't ever really write. I don't write on the road.